Well, looking at there are no financial disclosure. Why do you need photo documentation? As Dr. Yukesha mentioned, that it's important in the current era, from the patient education, documentation of rare conditions, for treatment planning, editing and archival software to, you know, edit and store these photographs. We published this article back in IGO back in 2003, and at that point of time we were using the Nikon Coolpix, and we were just using that to attach it to the slit lamp eyepiece and click photographs, and we were doing that for quite some time, and we thought that why not share it with our colleagues. Since then we moved on to using the Sony simple point and shoot camera, which was the DSC-W50, and it had a plastic adapter which allows you to attach more lenses to it, and we found that we can, you know, we created threads on the eyepiece, and it could be fitted onto this, and this became a useful tool to just slip it onto the eyepiece, see with the other eyepiece, focus on the eye and just click, and you can get very good photographs. In this, we used to keep it in the auto mode, and you can, you know, switch off the flash, and you can basically take photographs. Don't zoom too much, just zoom about 10%, and you are still well within the range. Commercially now, this is available. This is from PPI Medical. They give you a 12 megapixel camera from Canon with a metal adapter and the eyepiece. Everything assembled together, it costs overall about $1,500. But still, that's a good investment. You can keep it and, you know, use it in your clinic to click high resolution photographs, which are pretty good. And that's how this camera looks. You can just slip it onto the eyepiece and click photographs. What you see is what you get, so there is no science involved in that. And since you put the camera in the auto mode, you don't have to adjust too many things on the camera. And you can see these are some of the sample photographs, and you can look at the excellent resolution, whether you take diffuse illumination or you take retro illumination. And it's very useful to explain to your patient. Now, if you consider this photograph where the patient has had, you know, a subluxated eye, well, you can take this photograph, explain to the patient what the condition is and what needs to be done. Or if I have done an intact implant, I can go back to the patient and show him that, or that's an eye seal that's been put into the eye. Even if you take an external photograph without any slit lamp, this is just a photograph clicked with the flash on and the camera in the macro mode. You can see that this looks like a slit lamp photograph. This is just an external photograph that you have clicked. Even that's quite simple to take that and record and keep it in your brightness. Now, with the advent of smartphones, which where the resolution of the camera has been increasing, you know, every year they come out with, you know, first two megapixel, then 5 megapixel. Now you talk about 40 megapixel. Which Nokia has. So, you know, you can go on taking high resolution photographs. This is an adapter that was available from Keener, and this they had it for their handheld slit lamp. I looked at it and I said, why can't we use it for our existing slit lamp? We took that, you attach your iPhone 4 onto that, that's the eyepiece of the top one slit lamp. We could just slip it inside this, and this you attach it to the slit lamp, and we could take the same diameter that can slip onto the, you know, slit lamp eyepiece, and we just cut it off, made a hole in the center, fixed it onto this the iPhone cover, and we realized that all I can see, and this is wonderful, and I have this for my iPhone 4 as well as now for the iPhone 5. The advantage is that the opening that it has behind, it's quite big, so it's not dependent on what type of slit lamp eyepiece you have. So it can go over any eyepiece of the slit lamp. It can even go over to the observer sight piece of the microscope as well. You can just slip it on, and there is a knob here. When you clip it on, there is a rubber tubing that kind of, you know, clamps the eyepiece. It makes the diameter smaller, and it clings onto that. And you have to used to think that you need an expensive photo slit lamp to click photograph, otherwise you cannot. And when you go for meetings, you know, sort of achievement in that, and you know very well you should do it. And just to give you the kind of quality, because a lot initially people said, no, whatever you take with the phone, you will not get as good as what you get with the photo slit lamp. Look at it, that's the cornea in cross section, you know. That's the diffuse anterior segment, that's an amygdala there, that's the intact. You can see in cross section that's the DM detachment. So you name it with everything you can. The disadvantage, sometimes you may not have the luxury of doing that, and you know, instead of asking the patient to shine the light on his own eye, which is also not really good. So there's a small attachment that's available, which has a small battery power pack inside. And when you switch it on, the LED light, well, you don't need to go in for such expensive things as well. If you go, you have a lot of these LED lights which are available now, which are USB powered, or you get these for reading the books in the dark. You know, you can just get one with a flexible arm. And if you look at your slit lamp, most of the slit lamps have a small focusing, you know, knob on the side, which allows you, the patient, to focus on that. that still has the power supply. If not, you can just create a power supply. This can work on 1.5 to 3 volts. Create that, and you can have a diffuse light that can shine on the eye. And you can get a photograph like this where you can show the split image as well as have a overall image. In terms of videos, these phones, you can look at these two videos that have been clicked on split lamp, and you can see that you can get very good resolution photographs, the videos on split lamp using your smartphone. So it's useful, you know, you can take photographs day one, day 19, so you can follow up, you know, like an ulcer getting better. You can have different photographs of your surgical outcome. You can take the photographs and then create a composite of, you know, all these are all external photographs that you have taken, maybe for squint and different. And for editing, you don't need for photographs. You can use a commercial software. Otherwise, you can just put your photograph on PowerPoint. And when you try to edit the photograph, most of the simple editing features where you don't really manipulate the photograph too much. The manipulation happens in Photoshop, where you can do layering and you can do a lot of things which can, you know, alter a photograph. Here, you cannot do that kind of, this is like a basic editing. What you can do here, you can crop the image to remove the unwanted peripheral portion, because when you take from a slit lamp, you get a round, you know, there's a black shadow in the periphery, you want to remove that, you can use the crop. If you feel the image is slightly, you know, darker, you can lighten it using the brightness or the contrast. So you don't really alter the photograph too much, and this is quite simple enough to, you know, edit your photograph and do that. A lot of people feel that I have to edit my photograph, I need to, you know, use the Adobe Photoshop. That's not true. So basically in photo documentation, be innovative, you can use your existing graph. You'll be amazed at the quality of photographs that you can take. Use simple resources. These are quite helpful to manage cases. In my practice, I always do that. And you know, if you're an Apple fan, you can get something called an Apple TV. And you can attach it to your LED or the LCD screen, and then when you click with your iPhone, you don't even have to take any physical connection with the phone. You can just swipe and your image comes on the screen, and you can show your patient that, see, this is what I clicked, what you have done. So in this era, I think it's very important that you should have some sort of photo documentation in place. And obviously it's a learning experience, and you can get more information, and if you're interested in updating yourself in Cornea, you're most welcome. Thank you.